Hello everybody, it is Nia, and today I'm going to be talking about an indie game called Snake Pass. Now, so far Snake Pass is on PC, PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and it's also on the Nintendo Switch, which is the version that I'm going to be talking about today. So to those of you guys who live under a rock, Snake Pass is one of the most anticipated indie games on the Nintendo Switch because 1, it's one of the first palpable Unreal Engine 4 games on the system, and 2, the devs at Sumo Digital discussed how easy it was to port over to the Nintendo Switch, taking them about a week to get it ported over prior to further optimization. Of course, this information left a lot of potential Nintendo Switch buyers excited for not only the experience of having a playing Snake Pass, but also for the console's future in general. It's no secret that Nintendo has had a storied history with developers having issues developing for their platforms, so Sumo Digital did contribute to spreading some positivity around Nintendo's newest device. That said, let's go ahead and delve into my thoughts on Snake Pass. So first of all, let's go ahead and start with the story or plot or the objective of Snake Pass. So the objective of Snake Pass is that you have to find these crystals, pink, green, and yellow, to open up the portals to whatever the stage that you're trying to unlock. Apparently, according to the story of this game, the inhabitants of this world use the gates to traverse the mountain. So you've got 15 levels, and I don't want to go too deep into it, but there is a big bad at the end of the game that you will encounter. Probably not in the way that you guys think though. So first of all, you have a character, your main character, who is the snake in the game. His name is Noodle. He's gonna be the character that you're gonna be using to traverse the world, along with his hummingbird companion, Doodle. The way that the game operates is that there are no enemies. It's more so the worlds and the way that you traverse the world is pretty much the obstacles that you have to go through in the game. So the way that you're mostly traversing these areas is that you're using bamboo to reach high places. But it's not that simple though. The way that the bamboo is placed is in various ways. You might have some rotating platforms, you might have some that have a lot of twists and turns, and some that seem a little bit harder to traverse based on the conditions of the world. For example, you might encounter bottomless pits, spike pits, wind, and other obstacles in order to get the crystals and all of the collectibles that you need to 100% that level. Next, I'm going to talk about the visuals and the graphics of Snake Pass. So first of all, Snake Pass has a very beautiful art direction. And to be honest, I think that Noodle and Doodle are very interesting looking main characters. They do stand out and they do kind of leave their mark with you as far as they are designed. I never thought that it was possible to make a snake as a main protagonist look unique and eye-catching, but Sumo Digital definitely did that. I mean, Noodle is freaking adorable, Doodle is freaking adorable, and they're definitely memorable characters themselves. Another thing that I noticed about Noodle is that he is very expressive, and then you can also use the D-pad on the controller to change his facial expressions. I'm very impressed with how detailed the world is, although some of the stages kind of look a little bit samey. The way that it's designed in the game is that there are 4 stages for each theme. I guess you could say, like, for example, there is a theme based around hot coal. So you'll have levels based around this theme that kind of look the same so that the levels are uniform with each other. That being said, this game is beautiful and Sumo Digital is definitely proving what they're capable of considering the short amount of time that they have taken out to develop this game to the Nintendo Switch. As far as the visuals are concerned, the only downside I think to this game is the fact that it is sub 720p. Apparently this game is about 650p and it is 30 frames per second, which I think does kind of hinder the gameplay in some respects. So as far as the gameplay is concerned, with Snake Pass, at first the controls seem a little bit awkward because you've never played a game like this before. I mean, there's never been a situation where you had to control a snake. And in Snake Pass, the way that you control Noodle, you literally have to control this game as if you are controlling a snake. So you've got the face buttons, you use the A button to lift Noodle's head, you use ZR to move Noodle to make him move forward. You've got ZL, which is used to have Noodle grip whatever platform he's trying to wrap himself around and kind of have a firmer grasp. You're using the left stick as a way of kind of maneuvering and slithering in the direction that you want Noodle to go. And then, of course, you're using your right stick in order to move the camera. But of course, you know, the more that you're playing around in Snake Pass and the more that you're figuring out Noodle's movesets, the more natural it becomes. However, there's a huge problem in Snake Pass when you're considering the camera. You know, you've already got the maneuverability of Noodle and trying to control essentially every aspect of his body, and then you've got this added obstacle with the camera moving a little too slowly, which could honestly be the make or break between whether or not you traverse each platform successfully. For example, there are some moments in the game where you are wrapping yourself around rotating platforms, and if you're not able to move your camera in time, you're not going to be able to stay on that platform for very long, and it could cause you to die, fall into the abyss, or to hot cold or something like that. And to be honest, that was pretty much part of the most frustrating part of the game for me, was not being able to have that much control over the camera positioning, the angle, and the speed. And the fact that this game is 30 frames per second, I feel that the game kind of felt unnecessarily slow. Now, there is a mechanic in Snake Pass where you slither, and if you slither, you move quicker. But even with the slither, I still felt like Noodle in some ways moved a little bit slower than I would have preferred. That being said, the whole concept of Snake Pass is more in the position of a physics platformer. The way that Sumo Digital has been advertising this game has been more along the lines of a traditional puzzle platformer. And while I do think that Snake Pass has a lot of puzzle elements to it, it has a lot more physics-based obstacles and physics-based things that you have to overcome in order to be successful in playing this game and making sure that you're doing the best thing that you possibly could do to maneuver around as Noodle. And it wasn't really until the 8th or 9th level where I felt legitimately comfortable in my ability to maneuver around as Noodle. I also realized that when you're using your grip button to hold on to platforms for a longer time, Noodle's muscles do weaken over time. So sometimes that was a little bit frustrating, though I do understand why they put the mechanic in there, because I mean, they want you to be in the position of a snake. They want you to think like a snake, so it makes sense, but it is kind of frustrating at times because it seems like his endurance is a little too low. Also, one of the obstacles that I've run into when trying to control Noodle is the degrees of which he lifts his head. You have to be very, very precise and perfect when you're trying to lift his head to maneuver around these bamboo platforms. And that could be frustrating if you're not the kind of person who is accustomed to that type of play style. And also in the game, there's different checkpoints that you come across whenever you get so far in each level. And to be honest, I kind of felt like, considering the way that the camera system works, the checkpoints in the game seem very scarce as well. And if there's a situation to where you're already struggling with trying to maneuver Noodle and your camera is too slow to adjust to where you are, and that could be the reason why Noodle dies, the scarce checkpoints kind of feel like they punish you a little bit because of something that's not necessarily your fault. There have been so many times where I would progress through a level, or I was not able to progress through a level simply because I was not able to turn fast enough with the camera and was not able to see or react to what obstacle was coming next. Of course, causing Noodle to fall to his death and me having to start all the way over again because of the scarcity in the checkpoints in the game. One of the things I personally hate the most in games is feeling punished for something that I have no control over. You know, most games with a learning curve make you feel accomplished when you're crossing that hurdle and that you're learning to adjust from something that you did wrong, or you're able to learn a new skill in order to reach that goal. But in Snake Pass, overcoming obstacles can often feel more exhausting than exuberating when trying to traverse the bamboo terraces due to your character not being able to catch up to Noodle in enough time. To be honest, there were some times when I would just stop playing the game altogether and start playing something else just to blow off some steam. As far as the music and audio is concerned, this game has awesome, awesome, awesome music. It's very catchy, and sometimes it is a little bit repetitive, but it's so good you kind of don't really care. I love the tropical feel, and also I felt like the music fit the themes of each of the stages in the worlds. There wasn't a time when I felt like the music was out of place. And not only was the music, the soundtrack very good, but the game itself also has very good sounds. Like the way that you're kind of moving around with Noodle and how he sounds when he's kind of like slithering platforms and he's in the grass. Like it just feels very nuanced and it makes sense for what it is that you're trying to do in this game. As far as replayability is concerned, the main purpose of the levels is to try to get the 3 crystals needed to open up the portal at the end of the level. But you've also got these orbs that they call wisps in the game, scattered throughout each level that you can collect to get 100% completion. And there's also 5 to 6 coins that are scattered across each level that you can also get for the sake of completion. To be honest, because I had such a hard time maneuvering around as Noodle effectively a lot of the time because of that camera, I honestly did not feel compelled to get the collectibles. And usually I'm the kind of person that I like to at least take a whack at getting collectibles in games. It's kind of a part of my, I guess, my OCD nature, but in Snake Pass, I really just wanted to get the crystals needed to open the portals and leave. And that's really not a good sign. I think that if Sumo Digital could make a sequel to this game with some tweaking on the gameplay and also some tweaking of the cameras, or allowing the player to adjust the camera angles, allowing us to adjust the camera speed, I think that this game would have not been as frustrating as it was for me. I also had a couple of questions that a couple of people asked me on Twitter that I wanted to address really quickly. So I had a question from Anthonite. He asked me, is the game good? So although I did have a lot of frustrating moments with Snake Pass, I did find the game thoroughly overall enjoyable. You know, it's one of those kind of games that I think that it's worth a pickup if you can kind of, if you just kind of want something, you know, cool and laid back to play, especially in portable mode on your Switch. Nintendo Andy asked me, are there any power-ups or abilities in Snake Pass? And I will say this, but I don't really want to spoil the game, but there is a power-up, but you don't get it until the near end of the game. And whenever, if you decide to pick it up, you'll see exactly what it is that I mean. I also had a response from Los Dreams. He says, docked versus handheld, any noticeable differences? So I actually had a chance to play it in docked mode as well as handheld mode, and I did not really notice any standout differences. I think that it plays just as well in docked mode and in handheld mode. No differences really, but it feels good to play in portable mode. I also had a series of questions from iPod One Reviewer. She asked me how I liked the game. Was it slow, enjoyable, hard, etc.? Did you get any collectibles? Would you recommend this game and to what audience? Would you like to see more games like this on the Switch? Do you feel this game was made for the Switch? Meaning how fluid was the gameplay and did the controls feel right? She also asked me, was it worth the price or should it have been cheaper or more expensive, and is there any replayability? Now some of these things I've already kind of touched upon, so I'll answer the questions that she had in regard to what I maybe did not answer. So I did not get all of the collectibles. Would I say if it's slow, enjoyable, or hard? I think it's a little bit slow. Was it enjoyable? I feel like overall it was enjoyable, even though it did have some very frustrating parts. Whether or not if it's hard kind of depends on how quickly you can grasp new play mechanics and new play ideas. Like I mentioned before, I've never played a game like this before. You've never played a game like this before. I don't think there's ever been a game with a protagonist as a snake and you're actually moving the character as if you were a snake. So yeah, the hardness kind of depends on just you and how quickly you are to adapt to new play styles. Would you recommend this game and to what audience? I would recommend this game to audiences that like collect-a-thons, and I don't mean that in a negative way, but there is a lot of things you can collect in this game and that you actually have to grind to get because of the whole maneuverability of Noodle. So, you know, I feel like if you're one of those type of players who likes that type of play style, just trying to actually get the collectibles themselves might be a reward for you. Yes, I would like to see more games like this on a Nintendo Switch. I think that it's good. Anytime developers do try to make something new experiences, those are the type of games that I think will make the Nintendo Switch library stand out. I know this is a multi-platform game, but just in general, games like this and being able to play them portably, I think stick out a little bit more on the Nintendo Switch than they do on other platforms. I do feel that they actually took the time out to make this a game that did feel welcome and it did feel at home on the Switch. I think that the controls felt right. I mean, I don't feel like they weren't, you know, made for this control style and they were just kind of shoehorned in. I think that they did a great job. Even the HD Rumble, after the patch, there was a patch for the HD Rumble, kind of made it a little bit better, but I mean it controls fine on the Switch. It controls fine, and for $20, I think it was worth $20, even though it might be a little bit short for some people. But I think that the actual experience itself, maybe trying to get into something new, it could be worth that $20. As far as the pros and cons are concerned, for pros, I would say that Snake Pass is adorable and it has standout characters. It has good level design. It's a very well made game, very beautiful scenery and art direction. Great game optimization within short time constraints. It has unique gameplay. It is truly original. And it has a superb soundtrack and sound quality. For cons, I would say it has below average plot line, which is kind of to be expected for a game like this, so I didn't really take off too much for that point. It has a very steep learning curve. Noodle is slow. The camera angles can be awkward and slow, and overcoming obstacles sometimes feel exhausting instead of exuberating. Overall though, I do feel that Snake Pass is a game that I would recommend to you. If you don't mind any of the issues with the resolution, or if you don't mind camera angles not having as much give, I would totally pop this game. It's a very good game to play, especially in handheld mode, I think. Very relaxing game if you like physics-based platformers. So that has been all for my Snake Pass review. You guys, thank you so much for watching, and yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Don't forget to give this a like. Don't forget to share it if you did enjoy this video, and I'll talk to you guys at a later date. Talk to you later. Peace.